Okay, now we discuss the problems of level 1. Polymerase chain reaction technology, PCR technique, is used for. The first option is DNA identification, the second option is DNA repair, third is DNA amplification, and fourth is cleave DNA. So the correct answer is third, that is DNA amplification. That is DNA amplification, because during the PCR we know that one strand of DNA can be cloned into many strands. This is also known as in vitro gene cloning. So the correct option is third one. Polymerase chain reaction technology is used for DNA amplification. This is the right answer. DNA repair helps in to repair the DNA molecule. If there is a mutation, then this DNA repairs that. Cleave DNA is the cutting of the DNA specific location by restriction enzymes, and DNA identification is to identify the DNA. So the correct option is third. Now the second question is, Agrobacterium tumefaciens used in genetic engineering for. So the correct answer is third, that is gene transfer. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens used for gene transfer, as we know that Agrobacterium contains TI plasmid. This is TI plasmid. So first we disarm this TI plasmid. We can say that we remove the pathogenic sequence of this TI plasmid by cutting this plasmid with the restriction endonucleases. After cutting this will open up and we ligate here our desired DNA sequence. So this is known as recombinant DNA. And this recombinant DNA is transformed into the host cell. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens used in genetic engineering for gene transfer. Okay, it is used as a vector. This is used as a vector. Which of the following is an example of chemical scissors? Here, chemical scissors. Chemical scissors means molecular scissors, that is restriction endonucleases. So all EcoR1 is an example of restriction endonucleases. HIN3 is an example of restriction endonucleases. BAM H1O, it is also an example of chemical scissors. So the correct answer is all of these, it is a correct answer. Next one, which structure involved in genetic engineering? The answer is plasmid. Which structure involved in genetic engineering? The answer is plasmid. As we know, plasmid is a vector. So the correct answer is second, because plasmid is used as a vector. Plastid, as we know, is the cell organelle in plants. Codon is present in the mRNA. It is a genetic code. which in form triplet, which is in the form of triplet, like U U U phenylalanine, it codes for phenylalanine. A U G, it's code for methionine. So which structure in all the genetic engineering? The correct answer is plasmid. And now the next question. The next question is, TAC polymerase, which is used for amplification of DNA related with, okay, TAC polymerase, as we know, the correct answer of this question is PCR technique. So the answer is 2, PCR technique. As we know, this TAC polymerase is a thermostable DNA polymerase which is extracted from bacteria Thermus aquaticus, and this bacteria lives in the hot thermal springs. So this TAC polymerase is a heat stable DNA polymerase and it is used in the PCR technique. This hybridoma technique is used for producing monoclonal antibodies, MAB, in immunology. So this hybridoma technology is used for the production of monoclonal antibody. Gene cloning, you all know, gene cloning is a method in which we made multiple copies of a gene. Recombinant DNA technology is to make the recombinant DNA. So TAC polymerase is for amplification of DNA related with the PCR technique is the right option. The next question is, which of the following cuts the DNA from specific places? So the correct answer is restriction endonucleases. So correct answer is 1, that is restriction endonucleases, because restriction, as we all know, that these enzymes cuts the DNA from the specific location at palindromes. So these restriction endonucleases cuts the DNA from specific location. DNA ligase is used for joining the two fragments of DNA. Exonucleases cuts the DNA from the exterior end, like this, from the exterior end. Alkaline phosphate used to remove the phosphate group. So the correct answer is restriction endonucleases. Next question. Manipulation of DNA in genetic engineering became possible due to the discovery of. So the correct answer is again restriction endonucleases. Answer 1. That is restriction endonucleases, because restriction endonucleases cuts the DNA at specific location, and by cutting this we get the desired fragment by gel electrophoresis. So if we have many restriction endonucleases, then we have many choices to cut the DNA from the specific location. So the correct answer of this question is restriction endonucleases. DNA ligases again join the two fragments of DNA. Transcriptases used in transcription. Primase, like RNA primase, is used to initiate or is to form the primers. So the correct answer is 1. Next question. Which one of the following has found extensive use in genetic engineering work in plants? So the correct answer is 2. Answer number 2. Answer 2, that is Agrobacterium tumefaciens. 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 Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So the correct answer is this, answer number 2, because this agrobacterium contains TI plasmid, which is used as a vector. Agrobacterium tumefaciens is widely used in plants because it is used to transfer the desired gene in plants. Okay, so the correct option is second. Restriction enzymes. Okay, the next question is, the restriction enzymes are endonucleases which cleave DNA at specific sites, make DNA complementary to an existing DNA or RNA, cut or join DNA fragments, are required in vector-less direct gene transfer. So the correct option is 1. Answer 1. That is, restriction enzymes are endonucleases which cleaves DNA at specific sites. Okay. The second option says, make DNA complementary to an existing DNA or RNA. This is not the function of restriction enzyme. Complementation is done by primers. Cut or join DNA fragments. Restriction can cut, but it cannot join. Joining activity is done by ligase. Are required in vectorless direct gene transfer. No, in vectorless direct gene transfer, we use ballistic gene gun method or microinjection. So the correct answer is 1. Next question. The TI plasmid is often used for making transgenic plants. This plasmid is found in, as we all know, TI plasmid is found in Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So the correct answer is 4. Next question. Which of the following is an example of direct gene transfer? Yes, microinjection is an example of direct gene transfer. Electroporation is an example of direct gene transfer. Particle gun is an example of direct gene transfer. So the correct answer is all of the above is the correct option. Next question. PCR technique is used in production of transgenic microbes. No. Production of genetically modified food. No. Forensic investigation. Yes, it is used. Recombinant DNA technique. No. So the correct option is 3rd. Answer number 3. In forensic investigation, suppose we collect the DNA from the site, from the crime site. So this sample is very less. So first we amplify this DNA. First we make multiple copies of this DNA, of this DNA sample. This is done with the help of PCR. Okay. So the correct option is forensic investigation. That we perform this technique in DNA fingerprinting. DNA fingerprinting. So the correct option is 3rd. Next question. DNA ligase is an example that catalyzes the splitting of the DNA threads into small bits. No. Joining of the fragments of DNA. Yes. Denaturation of DNA. No. Synthesis of DNA. No. So the correct answer is 2nd. DNA ligase joins the two fragments of the DNA, or we can say joins the fragments of the DNA. Next question. The function of polymerase chain reaction is translation. No. Translation is the production of proteins from mRNA. mRNA translates and form proteins. This is called as translation. Transcription, no. In translation, DNA forms RNA. So this is transcription. DNA amplification is the right answer. So the correct option of this question is answer number 3. Which of the following is used as a best genetic vector in plants? Okay, again, so the best genetic vectors in plant is Agrobacterium. The best genetic vector in plants is Agrobacterium tumefaciens because it contains TI plasmid. So the answer is 2. Next question. Which of the following enzyme is used to join DNA fragments? So the correct answer is ligase. We discussed this earlier. Answer is 3. Next question. A kind of biotechnology involving manipulation of DNA is? Okay. So the manipulation of DNA is done by DNA replication. No. Manipulation of DNA is done by DNA replication. No, wrong answer. DNA replication means DNA replicates to form its copy. Genetic engineering is the right answer. Denaturation is not. So the correct answer is number 2. That is genetic engineering. Next question. PCR process in 3 distinct steps governed by the temperature. They are in order. Okay. So the order of PCR, we all know that PCR starts with denaturation process. Denaturation. After that denaturation, there will be the annealing. And after annealing, there will be the extension of primer. Extension of primers. Okay, so in denaturation, 2 strands of DNA get separated off. In annealing, primers anneal, 2 primers anneal to the complementary sequence, and at extension, tag polymerases extend these strands. So the sequence is denaturation, annealing, and extension of primers. So the option is denaturation, annealing, and synthesis. Extension is also known as synthesis. So the correct answer is this first. Answer number 1 is correct. Next question. What is the source of the TI, tumor inducing plasmid, which is modified and used as a cloning vector to deliver the desirable genes into the plant cell? So the source of TI plasmid is, as all we know, the source of the TI plasmid which is modified and used as a cloning vector to deliver the desirable genes into the plant? The correct answer is Agrobacterium tumefaciens. This one, because this contains TI plasmid which is used as a vector and it used to transfer the desired gene in the plants. Thermophilus aquaticus is used to get tag polymerase. So the correct answer is Agrobacterium tumefaciens. These all are not used in their plasmid are not used as vectors. This bacteria contains TI plasmid which is used as vectors, and all these plants plasmid are not used as vectors. Next question. The term molecular scissors refers to DNA polymerase is no, RNA polymerase is no, restriction ending is correct. This is wrong. So the correct answer is So the correct answer is third, that is restriction endonucleases. The in ECO R1, in ECO R1, the R stands for, as all we know, this E is the name of genus. This is the name of genus. This CO is the name of species. This R is the name of strain. That actually is RY13. So this R stands for strain name. So the correct answer is 1. To isolate DNA, to isolate DNA from fungi, we have to break the wall. This is done by enzyme. As we all know, the name of the enzyme is chitinase. So the correct answer is 4, because lysozyme is used to disturb the cell wall of bacteria only. Cellulose is a carbohydrate. It is present in the cell wall of plants. Invertase enzyme is used in the fermentation process. So the correct answer is chitinase. Next question. Okay.